In our first lecture, we have already seen that which variable to be start with and which variable to be end with. I repeat, inner integral limits are the functions of x, then they are the limits of y. Similarly, if inner integral limits are the functions of y, then they are the limits of x. And then outer integral limits are always constants and they are the limits of second variable. To elaborate this, we had some examples as well. Say this example, evaluate integral from 0 to 1, 0 to x e raised to x plus y dy dx. Currently I have only these scanned notes, that's why visibility is a problem. So integrand is e raised to x plus y. It can be written as e raised to x into e raised to y. Okay, now as already told, inner integral limits are the functions of x, so they are the limits of y. Therefore, our first variable of integration is y. So, for y, e raised to x is constant, so taken outside, and e raised to y is only integrated as e raised to y limits 0 and x. For upper limit, y will be replaced by x, so it is e raised to x minus y is replaced by 0, so e raised to 0, which is 1. So this is upper limit minus lower limit. Now it is simplified. E raised to x is taken inside. So integral 0 to 1, this is only function of x dx. Y is completely eliminated. Now it is easy as single integral. So e raised to 2x integral is e raised to 2x upon 2 minus e raised to x is integral e raised to x. Then upper limit minus lower limit gives us this answer. That way it is very simple. So I repeat the abstract. If inner integral limits are the functions of x, then your first variable of integration is y and vice versa. Let's see another example. Evaluate integral 0 to 1, 0 to x, xy, dy dx. Now again inner integral limits are x function, that's why they are the limits of y. So first we will integrate with respect to y. For that x is constant taken outside. And only y is integrated as y square by 2 with the limits 0 and x. Then upper limit minus lower limit gives us answer 1 by 8. Now in this lecture, we'll be targeting double integral in polar coordinates. Here we start. Now polar coordinate, x is replaced by r cos theta, y is replaced by r sin theta, and dx dy is replaced by r dr d theta. Just like in Cartesian form, we had a choice whether to solve for x or y first. But in polar, we have to solve for r first and then theta. As theta is always constant, outer integral limits are constant. They are always of theta. Therefore, first integral is always with respect to r and their limits are in terms of theta. I repeat, inner integral limits will be the function of theta. And they are the limits of r, whereas limits of theta will be constant, so always outer integral sign. Now if you see the example, evaluate integral from 0 to pi by 4, integral from 0 to root cos 2 theta, r upon 1 plus r square whole square dr d theta. As already told, inner integral limits are in terms of theta, so they are the limits of r. In polar, we have to always solve for r as far as r syllabus is concerned, and then we solve for theta. So 0 to pi by 4 as it is. If you see, this r upon 1 plus r square bracket square is a derivative of minus 1 upon 1 plus r square. If you differentiate this, you get current integrand. Therefore, its integral is minus 1 by 1 plus r square. I repeat, if you differentiate 1 upon 1 plus r square, you get minus 1 upon denominator square into derivative of denominator. Into derivative of denominator is 2r. 2 is missing here. That's why we multiplied and divided by 2. Okay. Now r is replaced by upper limit root cos 2 theta and then lower limit. When we go for upper limit, we have 1 upon 1 plus cos 2 theta. As upper limit, here it is written secondly, minus 0 as r, therefore minus 1 only, so is written in this way. It is simplified further. 1 plus cos 2 theta is the 2 cos square theta, which is sec square theta at numerator, and then it is integrated in the limits 0 and pi by 4, and we got the answer. So in polar also, we have to solve first for r and then for theta to get constant answer. Now there are many examples for practice. Now we'll go for the important part, that is change the order of integration. Dear students, there will be fixed 6 marks question on this topic, that is change the order of integration and evaluate. So here limits are always given, we just have to solve it by changing the order. Now very first question comes, what is the order of integration? Okay, only word is different, we have already seen it. If you are solving first with respect to x and then with respect to y, this is called order of integration, x then y, or y then x. So by observing given integral, we know which variable is given first to integrate. So we have to make it second. That is the only thing we have to do. Okay. Now we'll see another example on change the order of integration and evaluate. Integral from 0 to 1, integral from 4y to 4 e raised to x square dx dy. Now friends, you can see inner integral limits are the functions of y, so they must be the limits of x. So therefore these four limits are nothing but the four curves. So 4y is the value of x, 4 is the value of x, that's why x is equal to 4y, x is equal to 4. Outer integral limits y equal to 0 and y equal to 1. These are the four curves. If we draw, we get such figure. Then this dotted area is nothing but our area of integration. And what is the order of integration given? First variable of integration is x. That's why first we need to solve for x and then y is the order of integration. Now what we have to do? We have to reverse the integration limits. So I repeat, order of integration is here given is first x and then y. That's why they have considered horizontal strip. Now we have to consider vertical strip. So for horizontal strip, you can see x is varying from 4y to 4, which is given limit. Now if we consider vertical strip in the same region, vertically y is varying. So y is varying from this line, which is x axis, where y is 0, and it is ending on this line where x is 4y. Therefore on vertical strip, y is varying from 0 to, on vertical strip y is varying from 0 to this line. On this line value of y is x upon 4, which is upper limit. Whereas for x, consider full region. So x is varying from 0 to x is equal to 4. So these limits are given here with the integrand. Now we have to solve first for y and then x. So with respect to y, e raised to x square is constant, so outside, and only one dy to be integrated with respect to y. Therefore upper limit minus lower limit. So we get here e raised to x square into x dx. Now if you put x square as a t, we get 2x dx as dt. So x dx can be substituted as dt upon 2 here, x dx. So it gives us e raised to t dt upon 2. So 1 by 8, e raised to t is integral is e raised to t. So upper limit minus lower limit gives us 1 by 8 e raised to 16 minus 1. So this way, if vertical strip is given, we have to take horizontal, vice versa. Now let's see another example. Change the order of integration and evaluate. This is very important example. Integral from 0 to 5, 2 minus x to 2 plus x dx dy. Here integrand is 1. Now again, as usual, inner integral limits are the functions of x. Therefore they are the limits of y. I repeat, these are the functions of x, therefore they are the limits of y. It means first they have given y and then x. This is the order of integration. First y, then x. Since first is y, they have considered vertical strip and we are asked to take horizontal strip, and that is the change of order. Therefore, but the problem is, if we take horizontal strip here, friends, these four limits are nothing but the four curves, y equal to 2 minus x, 2 plus x, x is equal to 0, x equal to 5. If we draw them, we get this triangular region. Now, vertical strip is a given strip. While taking horizontal strip, if you see, if you draw strip here in first quadrant, then strip is starting from y equal to 2 plus x and it is ending on x is equal to 5. Whereas, if you draw it here, it is changing. It is starting from another straight line and ending on same straight line. Therefore, strip is changing its limit from the point D. That's why at point D, we have put a partition DB. So, in ABD region, in this triangle, if you move this strip anywhere in the region, it is starting on the same line, it is ending on the same line. Whereas, in BCD triangle, if you move this strip anywhere in the region, it is starting from y equal to 2 minus x and it is ending on x is equal to 5. So, we have partitioned the region. I repeat, if strip is changing its limit, we have to partition the region. Okay, and we have to solve them separately. Like this, in ABD region, in this upper triangular, x is varying from this line, y equal to 2 plus x. So, x value will be y minus 2, which is lower limit, to x is equal to 5, is upper limit. Whereas, y is starting from line BD to the point A. It means y equal to 2 to y equal to 7. These are the limits of y. Whereas in BCD, that is lower triangle, x is varying from this straight line. So on this straight line, x value is 2 minus y. Convert this equation into x equal to form. So x equal to 2 minus y to x is equal to 5 is upper limit. Whereas in this triangle, bottommost point of y, bottommost point of region is a C where y is a minus 3 and topmost point is a line actually BD on which y is 2. Therefore, these are the limits of y. Now, these two regions are nothing but the addition of these two integrals with their limits. And now, using usual method, it is solved and we got the answer 25. So, this way we can change the order of integration. So, the concept of order of integration is, if given strip is vertical, we have to consider horizontal and vice versa. While making so, we may require the partition the region. Okay, we'll have another example. Now, change the order of integration and evaluate. Double integral over R, R is the region, x square dx dy. Now, listen. Here, limits are not given. So, in that case, we can consider dx and dy range. It means first variable is x and then y. If first variable of integration is x, it means given strip is horizontal. So, we have to consider vertical strip for solving. Now, R is a region bounded by these four curves. Xy is equal to xa square, which is rectangular hyperbola. Then x is equal to 2a, a straight line, y equal to 0, a straight line rather x-axis, and y equal to x, a straight line passing through origin in first quadrant. Now, if you draw them, we get such figure. And this dotted region is our area of integration. Again, like previous example, we have to consider vertical strip, but if you draw it here, upper limit is the straight line y equal to x, but if you draw it here, upper limit is a rectangular hyperbola. Now, limit is changing from point B, that's why we have vertical separation or vertical partition. So, we have two regions here, OAB, in which now upper limit is same, and another region ABCD, where upper limit is uniform. Therefore, and all these points O, A, B, C, D, their coordinates are written here. Now, consider region wise. In OAB region triangle, Y is varying vertically. So, Y is varying from line OA, that is X axis, where Y is 0, to the upper limit Y equal to X. And X is varying from O to line AB, that's where 0 to A. In this region ABCD, Y is varying from X axis, which is a 0, to the upper limit. Now, strip is ending on hyperbola, where Y value is A square divided by X. Convert this equation into Y equal to form. So, A square by X is upper limit. And X is varying from point A, rather line AB to CD. It means A to 2A. Now, integral is nothing but addition of these two. 0 to A, 0 to X. Our order of integration is now Y first and then X. So, with respect to Y, X square is constant, so taken outside. And integral of 1 is Y. For upper limit and lower limit is x minus 0, and here upper minus lower a square by x minus 0. Now it is integrated and we got answer 7a raised to 4 divided by 4. Thank you. There are many examples for practice. Please try to solve and get the answer. For any query, you can contact me. Thank you.